Greetings everyone, this is Kavita, welcome back to the channel, and today's video will contain a lot of information on how can one improve his or her performance in the chemistry exam. So when we talk about class 12th, that is the next year when you're going to appear for the board exam in the year 2020, what changes are going to be there from past year and this year? So unlike past year, you had the chapter solid state. Now the solid state chapter has been removed from your syllabus, and now we also have the removal of group 15 from your P block chapter. So we have total two changes in the examination paper. That is, the solid state chapter has been done away with, and the second thing is that you have got the removal of group 15 also from the P block. So total, if you see, there are going to be 15 chapters in this year's paper, that is 2020. The second thing is that the paper pattern remains the same, and you'll be having a little more number of choices in the question paper. Okay, so let's see what are the things which you need to do so that you can improve your performance. The first thing is that you need to understand that there are two books in chemistry, NCERT part 1 and part 2. So in order to score good marks in exam, you must be thoroughly prepared and you must be thoroughly in touch with your textbooks. So the first point and the first tip is that you must read your textbook thoroughly. The second tip for everyone is that whenever the teacher is going to teach a particular topic in the class next day, for example, if the teacher is going to teach amines tomorrow, so you need to study that chapter beforehand and give it a quick review and study so that you can be a little bit prepared for what she is going to teach or he is going to teach. And this will help you to understand that which topics are you finding a bit difficult, so that the next day when the teacher teaches, you are mentally prepared that yes, this is the sequence going to be, and you can also ask questions to the teacher at that time. The next tip is that please be active in the class. Now the teacher is going to teach a big lot of children in the class from a strength of 40 to 50, let us assume. So it is not possible for a teacher to pay attention to all the children. So as a child, you need to look at your own benefit and actively participate in the class by answering in the class, by asking doubts in the class, and by being very prompt whenever an opportunity is given to you. Now, when the teacher is giving notes in the classroom, it's not only necessary to take down the notes of a teacher, but also when she's discussing something, the verbal clues she's giving or some extra points she's giving, it is imperative and important for everyone to write all those points, because this will help you in understanding the subject in a better way. Now, chemistry consists of different variety of branches. Like, you have four chapters of physical chemistry in your part one. So basically these chapters are very scoring, and if you study these chapters thoroughly and practice their numericals, it will be doing a very good thing. So for this, you must make a separate notebook for numericals and practice as much as possible. You will also find that in physical chemistry there are four chapters, and these four chapters are going to be very scoring. So it is very simple chapters, first of all. So you need to take down whatever formulae are coming up in these chapters based on the chapters, like kinetics is there, or solutions is there, or electrochemistry is there. There will be some important formulae. So these formulae can be written on flashcards, and these flashcards can be put on your study table somewhere, so that every day you can just go through them and revise them daily. A separate notebook needs to be made for numericals, and as many numericals as possible you can practice. Firstly, it is important that textbook questions which are given inside the exercise as well as at the back side of the exercise need to be solved very thoroughly. 100% involvement should be there from NCERT. Then there's also a section of inorganic chemistry which comprises of P block elements, D block elements, your coordination chemistry topic is also coming over there. So these topics basically will have a lot of things to be learned by memorizing them. So first of all, there are many reactions over here. So I would suggest every child over here to make a separate notebook and firstly write on all the reactions which are given in the P block chapter and the D block chapters. And daily these reactions need to be revised and seen so that they become an integral part of your brain. Organic chemistry also contains a little 3-4 chapters are there, and they are quite simple chapters, but basically they will require a lot of practice. So chemistry, basically the thrust has to be given on daily practice, revision, writing notes. So So in organic also, you will see there are many conversions which have to be done. And these conversions have to be practiced regularly on a regular basis. It should not happen that I have just practiced once and then I have stopped. I should just go on practicing like every week. This Sunday I have practiced, the next Sunday also I can practice the same thing so that I can recall the content very thoroughly. Because in organic chemistry, you have got many reagents to be memorized and you may forget the reagents and the temperatures also, certain temperatures need to be learned. So to get full marks and to get better marks, it will be a good practice to keep on, you know, doing the conversions again and again. The next thing is that whenever exams are taken in the class or there are some assignments or assessments done in the school, you need to learn from your mistakes. Whatever mistakes you have done in the paper, you need to come home and redo the same, you know, solve the question paper and also see what mistakes you did and correct your mistakes. In case you are not able to do it, you need to consult your teacher and don't hesitate to seek help whenever you require it. In chemistry, there are certain practicals which are done in the laboratory, like for example, you have functional group detection tests, then you have got some experiments based on kinetics. So whenever you're getting a chance to do something in the laboratory, do it with full dedication and be attentive in that lab also, so that these experiments will be helpful for the exam. The next thing is you need to have a very quiet room and a very peaceful environment to study. You must avoid any kind of distraction which is there around you. Especially the gadgets need to be avoided, television, mobile and all these things are going to take away a lot of portion of your energy. So these were some tips for your chemistry, and not just in chemistry but in all the subjects the same guidelines will be more or less there, that you need to be studying regularly and you need to be disciplined, you need to be practicing. And the book which is most important is your NCERT, because it covers the entire stuff and the question papers are set from NCERT only. In case of any query or any doubts, don't hesitate to comment in the comment box there, and I'm sure that you will be benefited by this video. Thank you.